The Karthus does fit in here as a time to pull it out.
But it's a bit of a jungler's paradise moment for Hana, because consider that. You have, say, for example, the expected Tristana
moves earlier, and it was always J-Team reacting. Now 3 versus 2 underneath this turret. The dive
aggressive.
Is on. The Wall of Pain is in Norskaren, though. He is dead under that turret. A bit of a whoopsie.
We had a wonderful one. We're going to have to be on our game here, because there's a lot of crazy stuff happening.
There's a Predator on the bottom side of the map there as Hana is booped away.
Positioning, but what this means is J-Team pick up an Infernal Drake. Going to help them moving into the lake.
We see heading towards the bottom side of the map. Map connects another one there. Onto Lilvius. We've got
anyway.
A fight. Yeah, Hana's going to go golden, but he's on a sliver of health. As Fofo trying to be the hero doesn't land the chance.
The map, but doesn't get any plates.
And that's actually because they all end in that Rift Herald.
Hana looking at this Ocean Drake.
Maybe we need to find a new definition for next level.
Yeah,
it doesn't need...
What is the next level? Is almost.
Yep. All in all, Spice feel comfortable. This turret is where Norskaren has had trouble.
Charge as Fofo's going to get stunned up. Splice, this could be the team fight they're looking for. As there's the Solar Flare and Kobe picks up.
Thinking
the
about sort of ultra late game as far as those are large money, but a hold the thought as in goes Norskaren,
booped back by the barrel and is going to be taken down. J Team.
The area where Splice have made mistakes before, and Karthus not so helpful in that area. Mid lane.
Down in the mid lane, misses the chain as there's the cannon barrage. And that's going to help Fofo pick up that kill comfortably. And J Team, they found it. It ticks over 18 minutes and they're alive on the map.
And that could be the swing that J Team is. Add that to the fact that Norskaren is behind the item curve. And then once Splice lose the Sion ultimate, they can't really fight back.
Well, it's just a kill straight up.
Coming in from the Oblivion Orb onto Fofo. He's got his first item, which feels so pivotal on this LeBlanc. And the Trinity Force is done. We're looking for more of Malmortius, and then Rest is going to be very happy, and a lot of damage available here from Hana as well. So J Team might be able to answer here as Splice group up as 4, but it's Splice to start the fight. Solar Flare avoided there from Lilvi, who has a lot of DPS. Norskaren is going to feel it and will go down as now the rest of J Team going in, but it is the turret falling. But Humanoid's going to do the same thing, and Visitor Chachi finds himself all on his lonesome. Killer Instinct utilizes Fofo diving forward, but he's going to come back, will find himself a dead Sion to help deal with, and JT move towards the Baron pit.
All 5 alive. Xersei doesn't even have Flash to try and get in the pit. It looks like this one's going over to JT.
Should be unanswered here. Xersei will at least nominally walk up, but Baron should be done.
Yep, Baron is just dead before anything could happen.
Visitachi and Norskaren's frontline ability is void. It might just be light, and she has to back away from the turret.
Hey, that's true. Can't 1v1 a turret with the backdoor bonus available.
Mid-game difference, for sure, in this one.
That's
a plan under turret. One thing unraveled, another unraveled, and suddenly... J-Team
in danger. Koala now over the wall as Fofo misses that chain. He had so much practice from before as there's the teleport. But no, it's a disaster. Fizzy gets himself out of the way. And that looks like not the ultimate that we were looking for, but the shutdown does come in. Rest throws his...
Aggressive as well. Yeah. Doesn't have a lot of the defensive options that you see out of a Kai'Sa. Also has the ability to build something like a Zhonya's Hourglass to avoid the ult coming out of Humanoid, but doesn't have any of those choices.
Yeah, usually the pivot after the... Muramana into Rageblade is AP, which allows for
something
those
that might save him from, say, a Karthus ultimate.
Yeah, and even something like a Mercurial Scimitar
Elder, but this fight on disadvantaged terrain is Norskaren.
Yeah, flash in onto Fofo. It's Norskaren trying to solo him, though, and he's out of position. The chains connect, no stun available onto Fofo as Lilvi dives into the back line. Doesn't find Norskaren, as that's a decent knockup from Visitachi, but Hana is going to go golden.
Come in.
Over the wall, will he find the AoE? The Buster Shot to trade onto Fofo, and he has to press his stopwatch. The chain is going to land, and Fofo says, nope, it was cute.
No way Splice can stop this one. The second Baron will go down in favor of J-Team, and now there is no one on this map anywhere near the Elder Drake, and it is going to be to map. Fofo is split pushing. Humanoid is just abandoning ship up towards the top side of the map. Only 4 members to defend this inhibitor turret in the mid lane. And Fofo says, well, if you're not going to be bottom side, I'm going to destroy it. And he does so very comfortably. Kobe moves down, notices that the inhibitor has vacated the area. And Fofo
keeps going for it.
Well, J-Team have the inhibitor turret down to half health. The push is towards the top side as well. Visitachi will deal with that one. And now J-Team don't have to worry about the big burly Sion. It's one siege minion. Splice cannot deal with it. And that is the one that's going to finish off this inhibitor turret.
Whoa! That's 65% of his HP from 1W.
That's an Aoi. Xerxes doesn't have a lot of defensive...
I'll try and chip down on this third one.
And speaking of which, they got three oceans as well, so any poke is not going to be an issue. It is going to be for Norskarin, though. The Eclipse, he's saying thank you very much for that one. Cannon Barrage comes in. Norskarin! Oh no, he's got no flash. Goodbye. Fofo's in there. Has the extra damage. They no longer have any inhibitor turrets as Humanoid goes golden as well. But once again, picked off with the dredge line. Big damage from Ress. He's going to shoot him with his pistol. There's the Requiem, but it might be the dream for J-Team right now. As Kabe over to the side will find Fofo with the buster shot to try and disengage. But now he's dealing with super creeps. There's no way they can handle this.
Oh, there is so strong.
Damage, though, as Kabe jumps on. Finds the first one. Rocket jump over the wall. Fofo! Oh no, that was the wrong one. The mind games. He is going to survive, but Splice hold onto their base for now.
So Kabe over.
Even if it buy time, look at the base.
They have to just all in this in 50-50. Yeah. This is the play.
Oh, no, we're going for the teleport. They're just saying that, well, Splice, if you're going to be here, you're going to lose the game.
Oh, man.
Cannon Barrage right on top of them as well. Xerxes just going to be taken down as an afterthought. There's the Requiem. His little gigantic shield. But in the base, there's a pirate trying to steal all their stuff. Visichachi surviving for a long time, but that ain't going to win you the game. And now Hana finds the body slam flash. Humanoid is not allowed to head into his base and even has the Zhonyas to avoid the death there. Humanoid should be falling. The super creep's going to be doing the majority of the damage. Kobe underneath his last remaining Nexus turret, but it has no health as Rest gets shot away. And now Koala throws dredge lines to the fountain. J-Team are going to find the victory over Splice in the first round, Robin.